Hello everyone, welcome to Master Today's step-by-step guide. In this video, you will learn serverless web applications in AWS. We will use S3, DynamoDB, API Gateway, and AWS Lambda to make our site serverless. I will try my best to explain step-by-step. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. What we are going to learn in this video? We will host a static website in the S3 bucket. We place the HTML form in the site. Using the POST method, request send to API Gateway. Trigger the Lambda function using the API Gateway. Store the data in DynamoDB. We have already hosted a website in S3 bucket in the last tutorial, lokandhali.com. If you haven't gone through it, please find the link in the description below. How to host the static website in S3 bucket. In this section, we are going to replace it with the form where it will contain name, email, and message with the submit button. I had already made the form in the index file. Let's open in the subline text. It's in the footer section. Scroll down. Yeah, here I have already made ready. It consists of name, email, message, and submit button. And on click on the submit button, it will call the show method, which I have already written at the end of the file. Here is the show method. It will store the name, email, and message in the variable. And var API is equal to URL. This is the main thing that you need to understand. On click on the submit buttons, we are going to submit the name, email, and message to DynamoDB from Lambda, which will be triggered using API Gateway, so that the required URL will provide us by the API Gateway, which we will learn in few minutes. Using the XMLHTTP request, the data will send. Let's check how it will look. Name, email, message, and submit button. Let's start. Open the AWS console page. Let's check the S3 bucket first of all. Here are lokandhali.com and www.lokandhali.com. All files are uploaded in the lokandhali.com. Let's see the static files. Here are all the files which we had uploaded in the last tutorial. This is the index.html file which we will replace after we generate the URL. Now, let's create a table in DynamoDB first of all. Open the console page and search for DynamoDB. Click and open it. Click the Create Table button. Specify the table name. We are storing all the contact us info, so let's create a contact us table. Another, we need to specify the partition key, which will be behave as a primary key. We have the only name, email, and message data. This is only for the demo, so let's put email ID as a primary key. Click the create button. Okay, the contact us table is created. For now, there are empty items that we will fill from our contact us section. Now moving forward, let's create the Lambda function. Again, open the console page and search for the Lambda. Click and open it. There are zero functions for now. Navigate to create function. Author from scratch, okay. Function name, give the Lambda function name that describes the purpose of your function. Loc underscore lambda underscore function. As you can see, there are different options for the runtime. We are going through the Python. Expand the choose or create role. Here we need to assign the IAM role to the Lambda function to have access to DynamoDB and API Gateway. Let's create a new role for it. Open the console page and search for IAM. Click and open it. Navigate to the role menu. click in the Create or Role. Here are common use cases. Select Lambda and click Next. Search for DynamoDB. Let's assign full access. Another search for the API gateway. Assign administrator role. Click Next. Tag. Leave it for now. Review. Give a role name. loc_lambda@role. Description. Let's leave as it is for now. This Lambda role will have DynamoDB full access and API gateway administrator role. Click the create role. Okay, here is listed. Let's check inside. Here they are. Okay, fine. Let's move back to Lambda. Click the use an existing role. Select the Lambda role which we have just created. Click create function. Here you can see the layer Lambda function. In the left, API gateway triggers the Lambda and Lambda function to store the data in DynamoDB. Now let's move to API gateway, which will trigger the Lambda. Let's again open the console page in the new tab. Search for the API gateway. Click and open it. Scroll down. In the REST API section, navigate to build button. REST protocol, okay. Click new API. Give an API name, loc_API. Description, not compulsory. Endpoint type regional, fine. Click create API. In the resource section, navigate to action. From the drop down section, click create the resource. Provide the resource name. We are creating for contact us section, so let's name as contact us. Don't forget to check and enable API gateway calls. Click resources. We are going to call this API using the post method, so let's add the method. Again, navigate to action drop down and click create method. Select the post method and click in the tick marks. Integrate type. Integration type Lambda function, okay. In Lambda function, type and choose the Lambda function and save it. Okay, from client, method request, then integrates request to Lambda functions, and again integrates response to method response, and finally the client get response. Here, we need the URL to use this API gateway. Still, we didn't get it. For that, we need to deploy the API to get the required URL. So, navigate to the action menu, selecting the needed resources. From the drop-down, click in Deploy API. Here, in which stage would you like to deploy the API? New stage, dev for now, click deploy. Okay, here is invoke URL. You can expand the dev stage, click in post. Here is the required URL that you need to place in our code section. Copy the full URL, open the code. In API, paste the URL and save the file. Moving back. Now, if we refresh the Lambda page, the API gateway appears in the trigger section. Here, you can see API gateway triggers the Lambda function and Lambda function stored the data in the DynamoDB, which we are going to do now. Scroll down the page. Here, you can see the default Python code. We are going to place the Python code which will store the data in the DynamoDB table. I have already written the required codes. I am just going to paste it. If you need the same code, please find in the description section. In code, here we need to specify the table name of the DynamoDB. Our table name in DynamoDB is contact us. Give the table name here. We don't need to modify other here, so save it. Now, the last job to do is upload the index.html file in the S3 bucket. Open the S3 bucket again. Let's remove the old index.html file from here. Okay, now let's upload the new index file. Select the file. Next, assign public permission. Next. Next. Upload. Okay, done. Let's check on the site. Refresh the page. Okay, here it comes. Let's close the local site. Now it's time to test it. Not working. Let's check the console. It's blocked by the course policy. Issues are related to the API gateway. Let's solve this issue. Open the API gateway page. Navigate to the resources menu. From drop-down option, click enable course. Click in enable course and replace existing course header. Yes. Now again deploy the API once again. The URL will be same, so no need to replace the URL. Okay, now let's test it again. Added record successfully. Okay, nice. Let's check in the DynamoDB table. Refresh the page. Yes, here is all input that we have submitted from the site. We upload the HTML forms in the S3 bucket. Using the XMLHTTP request, we send data to API gateway using URL generated from the API gateway. API gateway triggers the Lambda function. Using Python code, the Lambda function inserts the data in the DynamoDB table. In this way, we can use the serverless architecture in AWS using S3, API gateway, Lambda, and DynamoDB table. I hope you learned from this video tutorial. If you have any question or comments, please make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. Also, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you very much for watching. Check us out for more in IT tutorial and guide on website mastertoteach.com. We will see you again soon. Bye.